Hello, this video will give you an introduction to the dynamic light scattering technique. DLS is an optical technique used for analyzing dynamic properties and size distribution of a broad variety of physical, chemical, and biological materials suspended in a liquid. This can be colloidal particles, bubbles, droplets, or molecules. DLS determines the size of particles in suspension where particles randomly move as a result of Brownian motion. DLS measures the speed of the particle to obtain diffusion coefficient. There is dependence between particle size and particle speed. Small particles diffuse faster, large particles diffuse slower. Instrumental setup is simple. Sample is illuminated by a monochromatic laser beam. Particles scatter the light. The interference of scattered waves generates scattered light intensity signal. Since suspended particles undergo Brownian motion, this motion results in fluctuations of the scattered light intensity. As a result, we obtain plots showing intensity changes with time. We can see rapid fluctuations for smaller particles and slower fluctuations for larger particles. Another important part of the system is correlator. Correlator takes very rapid snapshots of scattering light, nanoseconds and microseconds scale, one after another. Then these changes in light intensity with time allows computing correlation function. Then we analyze this function to get diffusion coefficient of the particles. Then, if we know diffusion coefficient, we can calculate hydrodynamic diameter of the particles using Stokes-Einstein equation. So, hydrodynamic diameter is a hard sphere that diffuses at the same speed as the particle being measured. So, regardless of the particle type or shape, whether it is a core shell particle, aggregate of several smaller particles, or particle with irregular shape, we still use a sphere to model particle diffusion. Hydrodynamic diameter depends on ionic strength, surface structure, and shape, particle shape. DLS analysis gives information about average particle size and also provides size distributions. These size distributions can be weighted by intensity, volume, or number. In number distribution, every particle has equal weighting. For example, the 5 nanometer particles is equivalent to the 50 nanometer particles for number distribution. However, if you look at the volume distribution, the 50 nanometer particle has 1,000 times as much volume as the 5 nanometer particles. For DLS, we normally report size distribution by intensity. Note that intensity is proportional to the radius of the particles in the power of 6. So this technique is very sensitive to the presence of larger particles or aggregates. This slide shows one of the DLS applications. The study was focused on how storage conditions affect particle size. Samples were stored at 3 different temperature regimes and then measured by DLS, which provided size distribution, which is percent intensity on y-axis and particle diameter in nanometers on x-axis, then average diameter and polydispersity index. Polydispersity index estimates the width of distribution. You can see that samples that underwent 5 freeze-thaw cycles, green line on the plot, shows larger average diameter and higher PDI value, wider size distribution, compared to other samples. The second peak at about 700 nanometers suggests particle aggregation at these storage conditions. In summary, DLS has the following advantages. It's a non-destructive technique and sample can be recovered. The measurements are fast, few minutes. Small sample amount needed, less than 1 milliliter, and we can measure very small particles. However, the disadvantages of this technique, it has very low peak resolution, it emphasizes large particles and smaller particles can be hidden, and proper dispersion can be challenging for some particles. Typical applications include the following materials: protein, biological cells, polymers, micelles, vesicles, carbohydrate, nanoparticles, gels. Finally, these are technical specifications for our DLS system, Malvern Datasizer, we have at MCL, and you can read more in details on our website. Please contact me if you have any questions. Visit our website if you want to submit training or analysis request, and I hope to work with you in the future.